Hare Krishna. Don't just work on our conditionings, work with our conditionings. We all have certain conditionings which limit us in various ways. So we may be short-tempered, we may be greedy, we may be addicted, and we all need to work on our conditionings. We need to work so that we can overcome those conditionings. But sometimes we find that our conditionings are so strong, so deeply rooted, that working on them seems to be like a losing battle. We fight and we fight again we lose. So we all, while moving forward in our life, need some sense of success, some sense of movement, some sense of at least progress, if not success. If the whole focus of our energy is on trying to battle against our conditionings, and if we fail in that, then we will feel disheartened, deflated, defeated, devastated. And such feelings are not at all conducive for devotional growth. So therefore, we can't reduce the scope of our spiritual life simply to working on our conditionings. We also need to know that spiritual life is so inclusive that it can work with our conditionings also. That means that even if we have certain limitations, we can still see how can I serve Krishna with these limitations. Krishna doesn't demand moral perfection as a precondition for spiritual progression. He says wherever we are, from whatever position we are in, we can start practicing bhakti. In 9.33 he says that Mam hi partha vyapashritya yepi syu papayonaya striyo vaishya satha shudras te piyanti param gatem. He says everyone, whatever be their past conditionings or present condition, still they can practice bhakti and they can become elevated and liberated. The same inclusive mode Krishna also exhibits early in 5.29 when he says that Suhrudam sarvabhutanam gyatvamam shantim richati. He says he is the well-wisher of everyone, not just those who are pure or moral. No, he is the well-wisher of everyone. And if you just accept him as a well-wisher, then we can progress towards attaining peace. That means we need to learn to work with our conditionings. Okay, I have this limitation. With this limitation, how can I still serve Krishna? So sometimes we can see our conditionings like a physical limitation. Suppose somebody can't see properly, they're blind, somebody can't hear properly, somebody can't walk properly. Now that will definitely limit what all they can do in life. But still, within those limitations, they can create a life worth living. So if we see our conditionings as a limitation, but not as a complete disqualification, then within that limitation also, we can pursue our devotion. As we pursue our devotion, as we experience a connection with Krishna, as we experience higher satisfaction in that connection, that will give us strength. And by that strength, slowly but surely, we will be able to work on our conditionings and succeed in curing those conditionings also. So thus, by not reducing our devotion to working on our conditionings, but expanding our devotion so that we work with our conditionings, we can get a taste of progress and success, no matter how bad our conditioning is, and we can keep moving forwards towards Krishna, hopefully and progressively. Thank you. Hare Krishna.